Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining me today for our webinar with Princess Cruises and the destination of Alaska. And we are so happy to be hosted by the CruiseWeb. We're gonna be getting started here in just a moment. Wanna give everybody the opportunity to continue to finish signing on. So thank you for showing up. And I hope that you're gonna enjoy this session just as much as I'm going to be enjoying sharing this destination with you. So, Alaska, so fantastic. So excited to be able to share with you about this destination. My name is Wendy Prater. I represent Princess Cruises as a business development manager and just thrilled to be able to share with you today a little bit about my most recent experience on the Majestic Princess. So here I am pictured in Alaska and so excited to be able to share with you my story. So before we go further, I want to talk to you a little bit about the destination leader and why Princess is that in so many different definitions. Around the world. And we visit over 100 different countries. We go to over 380 different destinations. And the reason why we pride ourselves on being the destination leader is because we really deliver so many immersive experiences, both on ship as well as shoreside. And we've got incredible partnerships along the way. So we're gonna be able to share with you a little bit about each of those, but today time is limited, so we're just focused on Alaska today, and I think that that's going to be enough to cover that specific destination. So come and join me. Most people think, why Alaska? And you know, everybody needs to have this on their bucket list. It really is considered the great land, America's last frontier. When you look at the millions of acres of just natural landscape, and it's really so preserved, you've got this beautiful unspoiled wilderness where you can go in and enjoy so many adventures by both land, by water, as well as by air. And it is just really exciting. So hold on, we're getting ready to take you there right now. You know, the three main reasons why people really are motivated to come and visit Alaska is because of the glaciers, the mountains, and the wildlife. Again, it's really unlike any other destination that you've been to before. It's truly a national treasure. And every time you look around, there's just incredible natural wonders around every corner. The glaciers are probably one of the biggest highlights. We do visit quite a few of these glaciers on our itineraries, and it depends on which itinerary you're interested in going on and have availability for in your schedule, but definitely talk with your travel advisor. Sometimes Alaska can be quite overwhelming because it is so vast. And so your travel advisors at the CruiseWeb are incredibly knowledgeable about this destination and specifically how Princess really delivers it in such a unique way. You know, going into Glacier Bay National Park, it is one of the most majestic moments. Having said that, I have just returned from Alaska. It was breathtaking, you know, as it is that you're going through the icy strait and, you know, you're going into Glacier Bay National Park. This is marked as really one of the top reasons to go to Alaska. And, you know, there's so many reasons why we really make this experience so universal for so many different ages, because there really is something for everyone. So when you think about the fact that our years of experience in Alaska has been for over 50 years, we really continue to deliver over and over again, year after year, these incredible experiences from both ship to shoreside, you know, with both our cruises as well as our cruise tours. And we've recently expanded our medallion class experience to now encompass that on every one of our ships that are going to be traveling. So we'll go into that a little bit further, you know, later into the presentation. So let's talk a little bit about what sets us apart. We do partner with some really incredible companies such as Discovery and Animal Planet. So really there's different excursions that are set up for every age group that is really gonna be quite fun and immersive, as well as informative and educational. So, you know, for those multi-generation groups that are thinking about traveling, this is really a beautiful destination to have all those experiences together. We offer some award-winning programs on board where it is that we have our park rangers join us. They're answering a lot of questions, especially the day that it is we're in Glacier Bay National Park. But then we also have a lot of great speakers, again, taking you to Alaska before we've even stepped foot into Alaska. So we do really offer this North to Alaska program, where again, we're bringing on local artisans, guest speakers, different experts to really share with you about the culture. And then of course, the flavors of Alaska. Who can resist that amazing seafood? So we're gonna talk a little bit about that, but it really does set you apart. I mean, I know before we even pulled out of Seattle that evening, I was already having an expansive menu of oysters, local oysters. They bring all of the fish in fresh. And I was also trying some local salmon. So it was just really incredible to be able to, you know, again, already be taken to that destination before it is that we even left port. One of the favorite programs of our North to Alaska program is the puppies in the piazza. This is actually where you get to interact with the puppies. They bring them on board and you get to learn a little bit more about how these puppies are trained to run in the future Iditarod. And it's just such a fun experience, because who can resist that puppy breath, right? And that that face. So, but it's again, just a great opportunity for you to learn a little bit more about the culture and a little bit more about the experience of what it really takes to really train for something like the Iditarod, when these experts are interacting with you and being able to give these guest lectures. So we pride ourselves in the fact that more guests choose a Princess for Alaska than any other cruise line. You know, really the vote is out there, as we are the number one cruise line for Alaska. And a lot of it has to do with our North to Alaska programs, but it also has to do with our repeat travelers who come back over and over again, looking to have that consistent level of experience, as well as these immersive cultural experiences that we offer on the ship as well as shoreside. So I want to introduce you to a little bit of the Alaska fleet that's going to be taking place for both 2022 and as well as 2023. You're going to see we're going to explore three different types of itineraries today with Alaska, because we do offer a wide variety of experiences. So we do offer a Voyage of the Glaciers experience, and those are going to be the four ships that are sailing on that itinerary these next 2 years. And then we also offer the Inside Passage. So again, that is going to be more of a limited sale. And, you know, there are certain, you know, obvious ports that that goes out of, whether it's a round trip Seattle or San Fran. We're going to be joining our newest ship, the Discovery, and that's going to be pretty exciting to have her set sail first year in Alaska. Now, most of you are trying to figure out what's going to make sense for you when it is that you're planning on visiting this destination. I will tell you, it's incredible. So definitely plan for longer if you can, but sometimes you don't have that freedom. So we like to be able to offer some different options for you. There is an option for you to see Alaska. That's your round trip cruise. That's going to be your Inside Passage. You know, again, you're going to see some of Alaska. Whereas if you want to see more of Alaska, you may want to choose our one-way cruises. This is going to be a Voyage of the Glaciers. So you're going to have two glacial viewing experiences, both in Glacier Bay National Park, as well as an alternate glacier, either Hubbard Glacier or College Fjord. And then if you're looking to see all of Alaska and experience both land as well as sea, as well as terrain, this is going to be what we are calling the cruise tour. So we're going to go over all three of those options today and hopefully better help you to understand a little bit about what we offer. Now, there's a variety of different ports of embarkation, so depending on where you're looking to sail out of, and of course, depending on which itinerary, whether it be the round trip, Inside Passage, or the Voyage of the Glaciers, will determine where your start point is and where your end point is. So let's talk a little bit about the round trip cruises. Again, this is the Inside Passage. Usually the option is anywhere from 7 to 14 days. You're sailing from a range of ports, usually from Seattle or San Fran, Vancouver or LA. It looks like we are listing mainly Seattle and Vancouver and San Fran at this time. You are going to have some glacier viewing experiences where you're cruising the Inside Passage, and then you're going to be visiting those southeast ports of call. So when you take a look at the map, the round trip Inside Passage, you're starting off in Seattle, you're heading up to Vancouver, you have a stop there, you actually head on through up to Ketchikan, then you stop in Endicott Arm. So it depends on which itinerary you're on. It will specify, you know, exactly what you're going to be stopping and seeing. Then your next port is Juneau, and then you head up to Skagway, and then back down through to the Pacific Ocean to Seattle. So, you know, again, you're seeing some of Alaska. Not every round trip offers a stop in Glacier Bay National Park. So if that's important to you, you wanna make sure that you're looking on that itinerary and talking with your travel advisor about that. So if you're looking to see more of Alaska, we have our one-way cruises. This is our most popular voyage because it's a voyage of the glaciers. This is a 7-day itinerary at sea between Vancouver and Whittier. So you can have that two glacier viewing experiences, the one in Glacier Bay National Park, which again is the ideal place for you to see those beautiful glaciers. And then depending on if you're going northbound or southbound, you'll see one of the other alternate glaciers, either Hubbard Glacier or College Fjord. So you really get a more of an opportunity to have, you know, some experiences cruising in the Gulf of Alaska, as well as more Inside Passage cruising. And then you do have what we call late night calls, which is a more shore. It's a longer time within the port set. So when you're comparing the two options, you can see we've already talked about the blue line. Again, that's your round trip Seattle. Now, when we're talking about the red line, which is the voyage of the glaciers, you can see that that's starting off in Vancouver. And I just a little tip here, I always encourage you, regardless of what your port of call is for your start, is really talk to your travel advisor about doing one or two different pre-nights, because it's a great way for you to be able to explore the existing city that you're in. And I just gotta tell you, I loved Seattle. So that again was my most recent experience and just a lot of fun to be able to explore, of course, the Chilooli Gardens, as well as the Needle, the market, the famous market, and, you know, enjoy the local flavors of Seattle with the fish, had the most amazing seafood chipino there at the Crab Trap. So it is a lot of fun, but definitely talk with your travel advisor about doing maybe one or two different pre-nights in that city set. So after you leave Vancouver, you're heading up through the Inside Passage to Ketchikan, then with a stop in Endicott Arm, and then your next port is Juneau, and then the third port is Skagway. Then you can actually see with that red line that you're going right into Glacier Bay National Park, and then through to the Gulf of Alaska over to Whittier. So that again, you're going to see a little bit more of Alaska than what you would on the round trip Inside Passage. Let's talk a little bit about the ports of call, because those are really available on both itineraries, regardless of what you choose. And Juneau is probably one of my favorites. You know, just a lot of great little shopping town and just some fun opportunities for you to be able to view some wildlife. You know, again, whether you're exploring by foot, by flight, or by sea, there's a lot of different ways for you to adventure in this destination. It is a small town. These are some of my highlights. We went on a whale watching opportunity. Again, it was an animal discovery favorite. And, you know, this was just a wonderful opportunity for you to be able to witness. That was a whale we saw breaching out of the water, which is very rare. We saw some incredible rainbows when we were on the water, and, you know, as well as the fun wildlife of the local birds, you know, some bald eagles, as well as some sea lions. So, boy, they were noisy, but just a lot of fun. And then after we were finished up, we took a walk down to the Red Dog Saloon. If you've not heard of this location, of course, it dates back in the early days, and they're known for the drink called the duck fart. So you have to try it. It's, you know, when you're in Alaska, you have to try what the locals drink. So it was something of a fun experience, but there's just a lot of music, entertainment. You do feel like you're stepping back in time. There's even some fun different memorabilia on the walls. And this is a one particular one that I thought was interesting. This was a gun that was left behind at the checkpoint for the U.S. Marshal's office, and it's claimed to be Wyatt Earp's. So it's just, again, it's just a lot of fun. You get to meet with the locals, you get to really enjoy some local music and flavors. And that was just a little bit about the small fishing town of Juneau. And then as you head on, you hit on to Skagway. And Skagway, it feels like a frontier town. You've got these great little shops, lots of, again, great storytelling with regards to the Gold Rush era. I personally took advantage of the White Pass and the Yukon Railroad. That was incredible. As we were on this railroad experience, you had someone who was telling you a little bit of commentary about what went into the men building this railroad and how it took 2 years. It's 110 miles long. It goes all the way from Skagway all the way up to the Yukon. It's pretty incredible. And of course, it does get chilly there in Alaska. So they have each of the different cars have a heater where you can warm up. So you can go inside, outside to take some great photos. Obviously, the landscapes are very picturesque. You've got these small waterfalls, but so incredibly interesting to hear the history of how they built this railroad and really enjoy the scenery along the way. So Glacier Bay National Park is probably one of the most iconic stops that you are going to be seeing on our itineraries. And Marjorie Glacier is one that I'll actually share pictures with you. What I like about what we offer in Glacier Bay is that there really isn't a bad seat in the house, right? So if it is that you decide that you're not going to elect to get a balcony, I highly recommend a balcony though. There really is great viewing opportunities from all the different decks. You've got National Park Rangers that join on and really start to share with you a little bit more about this destination and the fact that it's a UNESCO he World Heritage Site. The glaciers are massive. Marjorie Glacier just alone is 150 feet above sea level and 100 feet below sea level. It stretches out for over 20 miles. And on average, of every day, it moves anywhere from 6 to 12 feet. So super interesting. The park rangers were so informative. If they pull up in alongside the ship in the morning, they join on and they're there for the full day to be able to offer information, and they have great little expert sessions that you can attend if you want to hear them talk a little bit more about specifically the glaciers as well as the national park, and just incredibly fun and informative and just breathtaking. So when I was talking about not a bad seat in the house, so let's say for instance you wanted to spend the day in your cabin, maybe have a little room service ordered or a bottle of Prosecco to celebrate the fact that you're in Glacier Bay National Park. You can do that. And you have the availability to listen to the commentary in your cabin, on your TV, in your stateroom, and also, be able to really experience this with one of your loved ones while you're on your own private balcony. And the ship actually turns 360 degrees when we're in Glacier Bay. So you're never going to miss an angle of a perfect shot. But I promise you, this doesn't give it justice. The pictures really just, to me, don't give it justice as how beautiful and massive these glaciers are. So this is a little bit better of a shot of the glacier. And just have to say, what's really cool is that on different times, you'll actually be able to witness the caving of the glacier, which actually sounds like thunder coming down because of just how loud and how massive the breakoffs are. Sometimes that happens when you're in Glacier Bay, and it's just a wonderful thing to be able to witness. The last port of call is Ketchikan. So this is just, again, another one of my favorites. I know I keep saying they're all my favorites, but they truly are because they're each so unique in their own way. And the locals are just so incredibly friendly. This is known as, of course, as the salmon capital of the world. You have this opportunity to really, again, stroll along that historic Creek Street. You have just incredible native history to learn about the totem. poles and of course the local culture there. This is a little bit of my viewing experience and some excursions that I took advantage of. Tongass National Park is just absolutely spectacular because of course the way that it's set and really just the overall depth of this forest and just how lush green everything is, you almost feel like you're in a fairyland. You know, that we went on a wild bear trek hike, and there is the picture of Mama Bear. Now, she was out the day before, we learned, with her, you know, six cubs, which I thought was fantastic. We happened to miss the cubs the day that we were there, but we got to see Mama making her mark down and through this path, which was pretty incredible because we were quite close to her. And so we took great caution to make certain that we were being safe, but we got some great snaps of her in action. You know, and when we were going on this tour, we actually went into a local village where we met with a local who was has been doing these carvings for generations. He's been working with both his father and his grandfather to learn about carving these totem poles, and it's really quite incredible the level of just precision as well as detail that they go to really carve out these stories. And you know, again, it's not a religious thing, it's more of a cultural aspect of what they do. These totems represent so much within their community of different story sets, so they actually will draw them out first, as you see pictured behind him, and then he'll write out the story of, you know, again, what specifically the totem is supposed to represent. So you know, it's just again, a lot of a really great, fascinating history as well as cultural facts. The largest totem pole that he's carved is actually over 40 feet high, and that was with all three generations. So I think it's pretty special memory, and he's currently training his 10-year-old on how to carve these totem poles. So definitely not to miss that cultural aspect there when you're in Ketchikan. And then also too, we had to take advantage of the lumberjack show. So I didn't do a bit of axe throwing this time, but I did get an opportunity to take a fun photo with the team and see them in action, to see these men put the tool behind the trade. It was absolutely a true talent. So much fun watching them as they competed against each other and riled up the audience to really just entertain and have a lot of fun. But it really does it look easy, but it looks incredibly intimidating. You know that there's a lot of knowledge, a lot of training. Most of these gentlemen have already gone to school to do what they're doing within these shows. So it's pretty impressive. So it was a great day in Ketchikan. Again, got to try some of the local salmon. The coho salmon is probably one of my favorites, the silver salmon, but I even did try the smoked salmon as well, and that was lovely. So lots of great opportunity to try some different and unique fish, halibut. You know, the local fish is just so fresh, and the oysters are fresh, just really lovely. So if you're a fish fan, that is definitely a great opportunity for you to take advantage of. So lots of different excursions. Again, we partner with Animal Planet as well as Discovery. We're really trying to connect you to the destination in a local way where you really get to meet with these artisans and these experts. You really get to see these this beautiful wildlife in action. And again, whether you're planning on exploring the great land by water and or by foot and or by air, there's just a lot to do as far as options. So you know, I got to meet with so many people, so many new friends, and isn't that the reason why we travel, is to just be able to meet new friends from around the globe, and you're sharing these common stories of how you spent your day in the city sets, and some were catching that great salmon and fishing, and others were exploring by air and took a helicopter ride up to the glacier and got off and did a bit of a trek. Others were exploring it by ATV. And one of my favorites is actually the story set was about doing a little bit of the trail ride with the sled dogs. So that sounds like so much fun. So that's on my bucket list for next time for sure. So regardless of how you choose to explore Alaska, you know with Princess, our excursions, our partnerships, they're going to be second to none. And it's really going to get you that local experience that you're truly looking for. So let's talk a little bit about our third option. This is our cruise tour. So we've already talked about our cruise. It's a 7-day, it's 3 ports, plus it includes Glacier Bay National Park. So this is going to be your voyage of the glaciers. So you're going to, again, have that second glacier viewing experience of either Hubbard Glacier or College Fjord. Then you're actually going to take a train ride. This is our exclusive Rail to the Wilderness train. It's a 500-mile trek into the heart of Alaska. You get to see all the beautiful landscapes by rail. And then this will take you from ship to Denali in 1 day. No transfers, which is fantastic. And then we have personal lodges that are in Alaska. We have 5 of those, and every cruise tour actually will visit Denali National Park, and every cruise tour will also have the opportunity to stay at Denali Princess Wilderness Lodge. Now, so this just gives you a great understanding of a little bit about how this exclusive Direct to the Wilderness rail does work. There you see the ship, you pull up, you get off the ship, you leave your luggage behind, it's tagged. So you're gonna, next time you're gonna see that luggage, it's gonna be in your room at your lodge, and you get onto the rail, you have this opportunity to really explore and enjoy the viewing privileges of seeing the landscape of Alaska by rail. You have these open air glass domed rail cars. So you're arriving in Denali on the same day. There's local commentary that's happening on the rail, as well as light refreshments are offered for purchase. So it's just a wonderful way to transition from going from cruise to your land experience. So we do have 5 lodges that are in Alaska. We have our Denali and our Mount McKinley, which are our largest lodges. Those are situated by Denali National Park. And then we have more remote locations that you can also stay at. They're smaller properties, more boutique-y, that are Copper River, Kenai, and then Fairbanks. So lots of opportunities for you to talk with your travel advisor about this. But the key reason why most people want to take advantage of doing a cruise tour is because you have the opportunity to see so much wildlife. So, you know, of course, the wildlife there, to be able to witness them in their own natural habitat. And again, you have this level of unspoiled wilderness, which is just fantastic. When I tell you, you take one picture, you'll take 100 pictures of the same item, whether it's a tree or whether it's a glacier or whether it's the wildlife, a natural bear in its habitat. I think I must have taken over 1,000 pictures during my time in Alaska. So it just, you keep thinking, oh, wait, now I got to get this shot. And, you know, there's no way I can get a better picture than what I've already gotten. And you really do surprise yourself, because again, around every corner is just an opportunity to explore. So now my ultimate recommendation is this new itinerary that we've put being offered. It's a 17 night. It's both land as well as cruise. It's 10 nights on land, 5 lodges. You're staying at each of those lodges for 2 nights. And then you have the 7 days at sea with the glacier, a Voyage of the Glaciers itinerary. And so you get, of course, this opportunity to be able to see it and do it all. This is seeing all of Alaska in its glory, plus it's fully escorted. So again, you've got someone there to answer all your questions, you know, about what it is that you're seeing, really point some different unique things out along the way, as well as storytelling. So again, just so much more fun. You have the opportunity to go into the tundra a little bit further in, you know, again, to witness that wildlife, again, experiencing a little bit about, you know, the gold dredge and the riverboat. So, and most of your meals are going to be included when you're on the land segment. So let's just see what a visual of that would be. It's pretty impressive. When you take a look at this map, you have the opportunity to, you know, again, start off, you're going to see that you are cruising through the Inside Passage, you're stopping at your main ports of Ketchikan, Juneau, and Skagway. You're going to be able to go right into Glacier Bay, then up to Hubbard Glacier, then over to you see College Fjord, you're stopping in Whittier, then you're getting the ferry, you're going to all of the different opportunities for the lodges, two nights at Copper River, then two nights in Kenai. Then, you know, you are heading up to Mount McKinley for two nights. Then you're doing a bit of the rail experience up to Denali, and then you end in Fairbanks. And, you know, like I said, the national parks are absolutely stunning. You know, you get to see, you know, what is that, Denali, Wrangell St. Elias. You get to see Kenai Fjords National Park, as well as Glacier Bay National Park. So you really can't go wrong with this itinerary. I highly, highly recommend. I usually always have the question of when is the best time to go to Alaska? And I always say, listen, if we're sailing there, then that's the best time to go. If it works for your schedule to go, I highly recommend, again, this is going to be a destination in demand for the next 2 years. So if you want to book and you really want to have that specific week that you're traveling, maybe you have a limited window of time to travel, you really want to talk to your travel advisor as soon as possible, because again, this destination will be in demand for the next 2 years. And May and September tend to be more of your value season. So if you're looking for a little bit better price point, but you know, it's great wilderness viewing opportunities as they're coming, the animals are coming out of hibernation. There's not as much rain. During the June, July, August, you know, you're going to have warmer weather. This is going to be, again, a great opportunity if it is that you're enjoying wildlife, you'll have longer days to be able to see and do so much, as well as, you know, of course, it's a great opportunity to travel multi-generation because it's summertime and the kids are out of school. So lots of opportunities to travel to Alaska. Most of you may have questions with regards to our health and safety standards and protocols. We want you to be able to have this level of confidence that when you cruise with Princess, we are, you know, going to be keeping you safe and secure, and you're feeling 100% confident. We've gone to great lengths to make certain that we are abiding by all CDC's protocols, really stepping up our sanitation as well as our health screenings prior to joining us on ship. You know, so you'll see here a lot of what's going into action, and just really, again, have that peace of mind. If you're looking for all of the latest health and safety protocols, I encourage you to check out our website and or talk to your travel advisor for more details. I want to spend a little bit of time talking about our Princess Medallion because it really is the newest form of technology at sea. This is a wonderful opportunity to really be an engagement tool for you as our guest, to be able to get to know some of your preferences, but also too to make your travel seamless. So this is an opportunity where you pair this device with your phone and or tablet, and you get this as part of your Ocean Ready paperwork in the mail about 3 weeks prior to you sailing. And you'll get a complimentary lanyard that you see that woman's wearing around her neck. You know, again, this is a device that you'll continue to wear throughout the time that you're sailing with us. And it really allows you to board the ship faster. If you have keyless stateroom entry, if it is that you're looking to navigate the ship or find your shipmates, you know, that it gives you great directionals on your device, gives you freedom to be able to play at the casino. Maybe you want to be in the casino, but you don't want to be in the casino. Maybe you want to be poolside and having a cocktail, but still playing on the casino. You can do that on your smart device with this medallion. My favorite is, of course, the best Wi-Fi at sea, because I can keep up with people that I love at home and also be able to share some of my stories of what's happening, as well as the on-demand service. So they'll deliver wherever you are on ship what you might need. So if you're looking for that, you know, perfect place to get cozy and start reading your book and just take in the scenes, you can do that and order your cocktail and not have to worry about getting up. They'll actually come to you and deliver it. Now, during this time, we've actually stepped up some and enhanced a lot of these features. So you'll see that we've even made it that much easier for you. So even now, when you are joining us for embarkation, it's all touchless. We are staggering our arrivals. So again, we are limiting the amount of capacity that's coming in at one given time. All of our safety drills now are offered for you. You can do those by poolside and or your cabin, and then just checking into your muster station. organization. So no longer do you have that requirement of getting together in a group setting. We do have health questionnaires that we do also ask as a precursor for getting onto the ship. That's also touchless, as well as our payments. So you're shopping in the store, you don't have to worry about carrying your credit cards with you. Your device will actually sync with any one of our shops to be able to charge. So ladies, it is quite easy to make all those purchases, as well as gentlemen, it is easy to be able to go ahead and take your chances at winning in the casino. As well as we also give you opportunities to also look at the venue capacity and how many people have registered to go to see that special speaker. So again, it's really truly touchless. Every step of the way, you have the opportunity where you're approaching your door, it automatically unlocks for you. It's gonna sync again with everything around you. If it is that you don't wanna carry your device, you have the opportunity where you can go and visit one of our local portholes. Those are our TVs that are equipped on the ship that gives you the opportunity to navigate where you're wanting to go, or to possibly find your shipmate. So that's great, again, just for helping you learn the ship. And speaking of shipmates, you know, whether you're traveling with a friend or your partner and or your children, it's just a great way for you to know where everybody's at. So you can look on your device and actually it will highlight on the ship by the medallion where all of the people it is that you're looking to find. So no more having to call each other, where are you? You know, you can automatically look on your device and say, oh, okay, great, I know that they're in the spa. So now you can head your way to the spa, or you can let them know that, hey, I'm poolside and I'm having a bit of a relaxing stint at the lounge chairs. Come visit me when you're done with the spa. So great way to communicate. You know, with our Wi-Fi at sea, you've got opportunities for even the kids to stream movies, you know, at home and or that game maybe you don't want to miss out on, as well as playing at the casino. You know, the fact again that we're having the best Wi-Fi at sea, it really does allow you to have so many privileges that you wouldn't necessarily have on a ship. And again, my favorite service is whatever you're needing. You know, maybe you forgot that sunscreen and you're realizing that I don't want to get burnt. You can go ahead and order that on your device and we'll deliver it to you wherever it is that you're on the ship. So whether that's a double cheeseburger with movies under the stars, or whether that's just a lovely cocktail that you want to like to have as you're reading your book, or again, that sunscreen that you're needing, you know, we're there to really help your vacation experience be seamless. There's lots of other opportunities. This app is really just unlimited. So, you know, if you're looking for more towels or you need a robe, or if it is that you want extra pillows or ice, we will deliver it to you. It just is a great way to be able to truly, truly transform yourself and be in the moment on vacation. The newest addition to our medallion is Dine My Way. Now, a lot of people have questions about this, but, you know, they were looking for more flexibility in their dining journey. So, you know, this is going to give you the opportunity to dine when you want, how you want, with who you want, and where you want on the ship. So you can set that up. You can link up, you know, whether you've met new friends or whether you're already traveling with a group. You can work it out to sync all of your reservations together so that you can be dining with a new friends every night, or, you know, by yourselves, or maybe you want to dine in your room on the balcony. It's completely up to you. You can set the tone for that. Yet it's not a surprise that we really have our repeat guests come back over and over again. And it's because of not only the confidence that we build within our product and in, you know, our experiences of how we, again, really deliver those immersive cultural experiences every step of the way, both ship and shoreside. It really is just so remarkable because our guests continue to come back and sail with us over and over again. And you can just take a look at the growth from 2004 all the way to 2021 that, you know, these are individuals that have come back and sailed with us for at least 16 cruises. So, you know, that consistency of service, of experiences is something that you can always guarantee on with Princess Cruises. We have different precipitation protection that's set up, you know, to give you that peace of mind, to give you that flexibility so that it is worry-free. So when you're booking your next cruise, talk with your travel advisor about this, because we do realize that different things do come up and emergencies, whether it be medical related and or, you know, for another reason that you're needing to cancel, these benefits really are there to have you have that peace of mind. So we have stepped up and increased our coverage, as well as also not only for emergency, but also too for even including COVID-19. So we will, you know, make sure that you are able to be in the moment and just truly enjoy your vacation. The best part about this is, regardless of your age, it's the same price point for your coverage. So, and we're not increasing this price, even though that we've enhanced our benefits with this Princess Vacation Protection. So definitely talk with your travel advisor about this other additional layer of insurance, and then this way you can make certain that you're traveling with the flexibility and the peace of mind that you want to have. Now, we do always like to call out different promotions and offers, and we want to say thank you to our military women and men that have served in our country and outside of our country and represented us so well. So we do have a military benefit of a $250 credit of onboard credit for both active and retired and disabled veterans. So this is available on any cruise, any length, and it's just a wonderful way that we can honor you. There are also lots of other different promotions that are continuing to go on. So talk with your travel advisors, because they're always incredibly knowledgeable about that. We know that really you derive most of your happiness from anticipating that next holiday trip. So get started, talk with your travel advisor. There's just so many different layers of really protection now that there really isn't any risk, only reward in planning that next trip. And so you can get started on doing that with your fantastic team at the CruiseWeb. We look forward to having you sail and experience a destination with Princess Cruises. We have over 35,000 crew that are waiting to really make certain that you have the most unique experience with your family as well as your loved ones when you're traveling with us. I know that you're probably having some questions, and I did see one or two pop up in the chat while it is that I was speaking. So I'm gonna take just a moment to answer one or two of those questions. One of the questions is, what do I pack for Alaska? What do you recommend? So that's a great question. And one of the things that I would say is layers, pack layers, because, you know, the season of Alaska, May through September, it does range in temperatures. So, you know, you may have cooler mornings, warmer afternoons, and then cooler evenings. So it's always best to pack layers, as well as a rain jacket, whether it's lined or not lined, depending on, again, what time of the year that you're traveling, as well as good shoes that are waterproof, that, you know, have a grip on the bottom of them, is something that I would recommend. Another recommendation would be to pack a small, compact, lightweight backpack, so that this way when you're shopping, or, you know, you're carrying around some of your different items, whether it be your wallet or your camera and or your phone or your binoculars, you want to take binoculars because, you know, of course, you want to spot that bald eagle. You know, that's just a great way to throw all of your items into one backpack, and in this way keep it everything in one place. So those are some of my recommendations. I think I do have time for one more question. So it looks like, how do you spend your days at sea, and is there really much to do? There is so much to do for the days at sea. You know, I encourage you to check out the local entertainment. There's so much fun, whether you want to have a relaxing day at the spa or take in the sights, you know, on the deck. You've got great lounge chairs. Maybe you want to catch a movie under the stars during the day or at night. There's great entertainment, a lot of comedians and different wonderful performing acts, theater that you can enjoy, let's see, bingo. There's just endless opportunities. So it really, you can set the pace on what you want to do for your day at sea. I was able to take advantage of a lot of different opportunities like bingo. I utilized the gym in the morning. And then, you know, of course, I had to make up for the dessert that I had the night before. But I also took advantage of going to see so many of the different shows and entertainments. And they had different trivias that, you know, sessions that were going on. It just, again, was a lot of opportunity of fun. There's something really for every age group. And, you know, so we do have something for also your younger age groups, you know, different clubs that they can go to and have their own space and enjoy. So I hope that this information was helpful. I know you have got some more other questions. Unfortunately, we're all out of time today. But I want to encourage you to reach out to the Cruise Web, talk with your local travel advisor. The number is listed there, and I hope that you get to explore Alaska with Princess, and you have a wonderful day.